buy the property. Because by after going home, I only have to do that. If you open it up, take out the seats, then I'll be more willing. Isn't that? So if that is a small business of taking out the seats and putting it properly and making it available to people, what is there? So this is the machine which was required. It is a unique machine developed by our institute. It was very well appreciated by USA, Afghanistan and different countries. Because it costs almost 1/10 of the what Israeli machine is about. Then we have this aloe vera gel extractor. Because aloe vera is very common. Everybody is growing that. Everybody is trying to use that at home. But this is, its bitterness doesn't go. And when we looked into the, what is the reason for bitterness, then we found that instead of just extracting the aloe vera juice and later on debittering it, if we remove upper portion, lower portion and just take out the gel out of it, that is the process can work for it, and this is the machine developed for that. Then this is a lychee peeler. This is our own fruit. Lychee is not grown elsewhere. If lychee is ours, we should have a machine for that. So this was the machine developed. This is sitaphal. This is also getting a lot of attention from the health people because it has tremendous potential to control many lifestyle diseases, this one also. But sitaphal is such a fruit that it goes bad very fast. It cracks and we have to remove those pulp out of it. And it is always done with manual, human hand, and that is why the hygiene is a concern. And then when you do with a human hand and you spoil the pulp also, and the price is almost 60 rupees a kilogram. Whereas if you can do it with the machine, you can get 300 rupees a kilogram. So this is the machine we have developed. This is the machine for washing. Carrots, when you look at the farm, they just come to the field market just like that, with all that mud and soil attached with it. Simple machines like this, if they can wash the fruits, spread them for some time, remove the surface moisture and take them to the... Losses will also be reduced, as well as the people get better price. Then this is a farmer who tried to make a machine for tomato puree and fruit pulp. Tomato puree and fruit pulp, these two things. For example, when you look at the processed food from the fruits and vegetables, what comes to our mind? Two types of products. One is the juice, which is made from pulp, and another is a soup, which is made from dehydrated vegetables. So, if you want to have more of the juicing industries or more of the soup industries, what do you need? Because if you ask them, take our fruits and drink our vegetables, they will say that that is not my raw material. What is my raw material is, if I want to make juice, you give me the pulp. So the pulping industries have to come in the region with the cold storage facilities for storing. Then for vegetables, if they want to make soup, they will say that you give us dehydrated vegetables packed in 100 kg bag and we are going to take them. But we don't have a dehydrator established in the villages, which are very easy, simple technology. Unfortunately, today, whatever ketchup you might be eating, for that the puree comes from China and the US. And our tomatoes are rotting in the street because we don't have the number of puree industries. Then the next is, this is a simple dryer, humidified dryer, to preserve the quality of the food. Then this is cardamom dryer with LPG, where things will not be available. Then onion peeler, some of the machines, the distillation machine for essential oils at the small scale. Then the shrink packaging of food. This is very simple intervention. In fact, each fruit, if it is packaged in a bag with this shrink packaging exposes the fruit to 175 degrees Celsius for short time. So it is something like sterilization of the fruit, and it is a special packaging of the fruit, and it extends the shelf life by 4 times. And this is the technology we have given for high value products. For example, this is Shimla mirch, what we have, pepper. One Shimla mirch costs 5 rupees. And the cost of packaging 20 paise will increase the shelf life by 4 times. Farmer can get the better price. Then these are some of the low cost cold storages where you can store the vegetables harvested properly for some time, because everyday farmer harvests vegetables and he cannot go to the market. Because vegetables are not like cereal that will come for harvest at one time. Season goes for 1 month. They keep on harvesting every 2 days. And every time he cannot go to the market, so he needs to have the low cost evaporative cool storage structures. So these are the environment friendly storage structures where there is no electrical energy required, just like you require in the refrigeration. Then this is the artificial ripening of fruit. The fruits need to be ripened uniformly. And for that, nowadays what they are using is carbide and things like that, which is not good for health. But here it is ethylene gas, and very simple structure. Then this is the ventilated air rate transport we have designed. Because they thought about the refrigerated transport for the vegetables and fruits in our country, and that will not work because we don't have power for most of the time. Then we said that you go for ventilated structures. So we designed the ventilation area and how they should be making that unit, this thing, with our technological consultancy to this agency. Indian Railways Mail, they have these two rail transports, one from Jalgaon for banana, and I think one they started from Patna for vegetables to other property. Then these valuation technologies, you make the different preserves, fruit juices, soup, chutneys, and those are the wonderful business nowadays. Because when it comes in the multinational, when it sells at higher price, and when you can do it and locally, you can have a fresh produce, you can have a traceability available, and you can make a good product for that matter. Then these are some of the products which we have developed. Guava, for example, if you want to have it for throughout the year, you make a guava bar out of it. What you need is making bulk of the guava, keeping it for the cold store, and whenever you want to make this product, you keep on making it and sell it in the market just like candies. This is something for beer. This is for sapota. This is for mustard saag. Sarso ka saag and makke ki roti is very common. And it is exported from Punjab, sarso ka saag, which is made. Then we thought that why not we make dry powder out of it, put hot water and reconstitute, make a saag. And anywhere in the world, the Punjabis, those who would like to enjoy this, they can do it. Then the green chili powder. This is a new technology we have developed where the red chili powder you must have seen. Why to wait for making it red and then dry? Why not we can make the green chili powder, which will have lots of nutrition in that, and that is how we have developed that. Then when we develop any technology or any research, that as a component we can never give. It should be given as a package for the new entrepreneurs. And this is the package given, the minimal processing of vegetables. This costs about 1.5 lakhs. A small entrepreneur can put it up and then experiment it. And all these examples can go as a small project work for real life projects of the master management students and people like that. Generally, when people ask me, they say that if you want to do summer job, instead of that, you put 10,000 rupees, four friends together, go for one of these activities and see that how much you earn. And that will be an example for others to know that how much profitable it is to work in the food processing business, and also how much it helps in reducing the pollution in the country. Then these are the equipment for cassava. This is mango machinery. This is turmeric machinery. This is banana, this thing. And then value-added product from the byproducts. You will be surprised to see that the byproducts what we get in processing, they are also highly valuable. Because many very high-order components we get in that. For example, pectin from fruits and vegetables, lycopene from tomato peel. There are tablets now which supplement, and the tablet costs about maybe 10 rupees per tablet, but it is from the like tomato peel, tomato seed oil, dietary fiber from fruit pomace, and all these things are available. Then all the peels can be used for cosmetics. Yes. Then pectin from papaya, products from amla seed, that is a byproduct. Products from bay leaves, bay is our fruit. Nobody might have seen that in the world outside. Then bay seeds, custard apple leaves and seeds, jamun seeds. Jamun has attracted the attention of the American population because they found that the jamun seed powder is very good for controlling the diabetes. And later on we said that okay, see, we have such a wonderful fruit. But if you look at the jamun tree, half of the jamuns they fall on the ground and nobody can even lift them. So why can't we have a collecting mechanism for those fruits and that kind of thing? Then mango stone kernel. Mango stone, after eating the pulp from the mango, when you have opened that up, there is a kernel inside. That kernel starch is so good, it can be used in infant food. There was one German student working for her PhD, and she asked me, called me and said, sir, I would like to have this in the larger quantity. And then I told some processing unit addresses, and that is how they are working on. These are the valuable products which the God has given us, but we have never cared for. Then these are some recommendations, proper process protocols we should have. We should have industries for processing fruits and vegetables in the production catchment. Because nowadays, there is a good, very good time for that. Because earlier there used to be big industry for processing. But when it is a big industry for processing, all the produce is pulled together. Then the, for food safety, the traceability which is required, that is not adequate. If you have the industry in the village, you can just point out that these are the trees what we use for making this product. Your international buyer is going to give maybe 5 times or 10 times more price for that. And agriculture can be really very good business. And once agriculture becomes profitable, the country progresses naturally. With this, I thank you very much. I think I have taken a lot of time.